Hi everyone, I'm Whitney and you're watching The Sitch. Today is episode 2 in my 3-part series on soy. As we discussed in last week's video, soy is a very controversial food. However, what we learned last week is that when it comes to soy and cancer, there really shouldn't be any debate. Studies consistently show that soy consumption prevents and fights many cancers. In today's video, we're talking about another hot button issue surrounding soy, fertility. Fears about the effects of phytoestrogens on fertility were initially sparked in the 1940s by the observation that sheep eating large amounts of red clover, a phytoestrogen-containing plant, developed infertility. Now remember, phytoestrogens and specifically isoflavones are the chemical compounds found in soy and other plants that actually possess cancer-fighting properties. Subsequent animal studies supported the observations in sheep, showing that high levels of phytoestrogens from a variety of sources also affected reproductive functioning. Studies in mice showed that injecting baby mice with high doses of the bioactive phytoestrogen genistein impaired infertility. However, as we learned in the last video, the human body does not process phytoestrogens in the same way that animals do. And the effects seen in animals are likely due to far higher blood concentrations of these compounds than those that are reached in humans. Additionally, injecting baby mice with high-dose isolated isoflavones can hardly be compared to the consumption of a moderate amount of whole soy food by an adult orally, which requires digestion, absorption, and activation of the isoflavone. In human females, there is absolutely no evidence that soy consumption impacts fertility. In fact, a recent study of women undergoing IVF showed a 77% increase in the chance of achieving a live birth for women who have a high intake of soy products. Another randomized controlled trial in couples undergoing infertility treatment showed an increase in live birth rates for those consuming isoflavone supplements. Alternative health practitioners also frequently advise patients with polycystic ovarian syndrome, a common cause of infertility, to avoid soy. However, studies show that soy may actually be beneficial for those with PCOS. A recent randomized controlled trial of 70 women with the condition showed improved markers of insulin resistance, triglycerides, and oxidative stress, which are all believed to contribute to the progression of this disease. The effect of soy on men's fertility is also a common topic of misinformation. I mean, I can't tell you the amount of concerned guys that have asked me whether eating soy is going to give them man boobs. Spoiler alert! The answer is no. While a couple of poorly done studies with small sample sizes and no controlled groups found slight decreases in circulating testosterone following the consumption of soy products, the bulk of the scientific research has shown absolutely no effect. A recent meta-analysis of 32 human studies found no changes in testosterone or other sex hormones following the consumption of soy or soy products. Other studies support this, showing no impact of dietary phytoestrogens on male reproductive function. Now, the next claim is kind of funny, considering it directly contradicts the previous claim. Some people say that soy actually increases testosterone and decreases estrogen, which then causes acne. This is also, unsurprisingly, not true. There are absolutely no studies suggesting this to be the case. In fact, soy may actually reduce acne by helping to stabilize blood sugar. High blood sugar levels and insulin resistance are both associated with acne. A recent randomized controlled trial in obese women showed that soy protein helped improve insulin sensitivity to a greater extent than the same amount of protein from meat and dairy. So as you can see, the claims that soy affects sex hormones and increases the chance of infertility, PCOS, or acne are clearly unsupported by science. And that's it for today's topic. In the next and final video of our soy series, I'll be tackling an issue that's a lot less cut and dry: soy and thyroid health. There are claims that soy negatively impacts thyroid hormones and leads to hypothyroidism, and we're going to explore those next time. In the meantime, if you missed the first video in this series on soy and cancer, be sure to check that out. And make sure you're subscribed to my channel so you don't miss the next video. As always, the references for the studies that were mentioned in this video are linked on my website. You'll also find a bunch more nutrition information over there and healthy original recipes to support your health goals. I'm Whitney. Thank you so much for watching.